Are you all, to start off with, DC fans, or have you always been kind of DC fans?
We are now.
That is the correct answer. What kind of DC stuff have you been into?
Not a lot, really. I mean, I enjoyed the Christopher Nolan films. They were sort of the ones
that hooked you.
Yeah, and they're just amazing films anyway, aren't they? And then that then sort of spiked my interest in it, I suppose. But I didn't really read comics growing up. And luckily, this takes place before
you were
the comics.
You were too busy watching Care Bears, weren't you?
You got me. Yeah. That was it.
I love that. But no, this is good. This is a good introduction because obviously it's a prequel to the Batman stuff, so it's new kind of for all of us. Obviously, Jack playing Alfred.
Yeah.
What Alfreds that we've seen on screen did you kind of draw characteristics from, or were you like, I just need to make him completely myself and completely new?
Well, Michael Caine's version of Alfred, he was the one who said, I'll play a butler as long as he's ex-SAS. And our story explores the SAS background. So early on, you know, in the audition process, I had a conversation with Danny and Bruno. Danny, our lead director, and Bruno Heller, the writer. And they said, you know, if there's any of the old guys that we're going to give a nod to, it would be him. So through the voice and the physicality, and also the fact that it's set in the 60s. I mean, Michael Caine sort of is the 60s, isn't he? Or was the 60s,
yeah. I could hear it when I was listening to it. Yeah. You can hear the little bits. So you got it, if that's what you were going for.
Good, thank you.
Absolutely. Mm.
Good.
Paloma, you're playing Bette Sykes. What do we need to know about Bette? Because obviously she's not a, you know, we've heard of Thomas Wayne, we've heard of Alfred. Bette, honestly, I hadn't heard of before. So what do we need to know about her?
So Bette Sykes was written specifically for this show, which meant that I had a great weight lifted off my shoulder. One shoulder.
One shoulder.
I only have
one.
And, so Bette's a villain, or perceived as a villain. I think, this is my own perception, she's a bit autistic. So she doesn't really read social signals very well and can't really understand why people think she's mad, which I relate to. And, she's a serial killer. She sees it as a job, though, so she works for people. And I think the similarity between Alfred and Bette is that they're both from a working-class background. And in Britain, class is what divides us in a big way, more than in America, where the show's been on already, where they don't really understand that because they have the American dream and you can be anything. So I think, she is... I don't think she's a villain, but everyone else does. Okay. I think as well there are times when spectators, viewers have fed back like, oh, I wanted to hate her and be scared of her, but she seems like, in this instance, like she's coming good and stuff. So I think what's clever about DC Universe in terms of like exploring the human condition is that there's always a thin line between what is a good person and what's a bad person, because inherently human beings are capable of all things given the circumstances. So it's not as black and white as it looks.
There is a lot of depth to that character there.
And that answer.
Great answer. Great answer. Ben playing Thomas Wayne. Is this the first time we're actually getting to see more? Like
see
a depth
him not dying.
We only see him die, don't we, in every other iteration of him. It's the first time. So, I guess with Alfred and with Thomas, it's all about we've got free rein, or Bruno had free rein, to flesh out their backstory. So that's what the whole piece is doing, examining who they were before we know them in the comic books.
I always see Alfred as the ultimate secret keeper. Like, there is no one better at keeping secrets than Alfred. How are you guys with keeping secrets? Are you good if someone tells you something? Like, if you knew Batman and he was like, you have to keep my secret identity and all that, how would you do? Or would you be willing to, be tempted to tell, like, your best mate?
I'd be awful. Don't tell me anything. I just have a complete inability to
Keep a secret.
Keep a secret, yeah.
That makes me love you more.
I'm really surprised by that.
Really?
Yeah, I won't tell you anything now.
I think I'm quite good at it, actually. Because
I can imagine if someone said to you, don't say.
But you have to say that because I don't. I can't really judge what secrets are.
So you have to
tell me it's a secret because I think everything should be shared. But if somebody does do that, I'm really good at it because I give the impression of telling you everything. So it's quite good when I need to hold information because I'm like, blah, 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 blah. But I
quite enjoy it.
Yeah, I've held the secret. What about you?
I think I'm maybe quite good at secrets. Similar though, if I'm told, I have to be told.
Yeah.
But if a friend asks me to not tell.
Everyone's got a different boundary.
Yeah.
Interesting, okay. Yeah. And what, doing this series, I mean, I imagine it's going to develop a lot. I'll be honest, I didn't get through the entire series yet, so I'm looking forward to watching the rest of it. But for you guys, what was the coolest thing that you got to do filming this first series individually?
Oh, you two got to do lots of cool stuff.
Yeah, all the action was quite fun. Bit of driving, which was good.
Having sex like animals.
It's got
mature rating, right?
Yeah. We can do what we like.
I saw that scene and I have to say I was quite shocked and I hope that's not how you do it.
No. That was the point. Yeah. No, that was my bonobo monkey.
Oh, yeah. It came across. Monkey. I was like, ooh, yeah. No orgasm coming from that
woman. Taking care of himself.
Yeah. I think that may be the coolest thing that Paloma saw. What was the coolest thing you got to do?
What was the coolest thing?
I've seen an amazing slow-mo clip of you where you're like, you're hammering someone to death. And you're
but they didn't even put that in. I was so disappointed.
She's getting a shower. Oh, really?
A shower of blood.
Someone slowed it down on their iPhone.
That was me. I did that, yeah.
They said it was too much.
It's just Paloma looking psycho with loads of blood going.
They did, but they didn't. They weren't. They edited it out and they used.
Also, it's hilarious because you're hammering there, but the blood's coming from there in slow-mo, so it's like there's
bloodbath, absolute bloodbath.
Stunt guy doing.
What about yours?
I can't talk about mine because I think it would reveal too much of the
when he
the
becomes
secret.
Superman.
Yeah, exactly.
He is good at the secret.
Cross genres.
I hope that happens. That would be amazing. Thanks, guys. Thanks. I look forward to seeing the rest of it. Lovely
Thank
to see
you. Nice to meet you. Take care.
Stuff in the sport, hold on. No!